Because this is a very important session to make sure that you get the two questions correct. So at 11:05 we will start. I think by the time everyone will join the session. So one more minute and we'll start the session. So I think we can start session. Those who are just joined now, for them. Okay. So I'll be teaching you today on how to do these first two questions. This is purely mathematical reasoning. And all these questions will come for your engineering entrance exam. Irrespective of JEE, any examination, these questions will come. Okay. But this is a strictly CET related question. Fine. The CET, Comet K, no much difference and no much difference in preparation. All are same only. So today I'll be teaching you how to do this kind of problems easily. So normally I'll do these things in the last. Okay. But I think it's the time has come right for me to explain to you this problem so that I'm sure that 100% of students who are getting attending today's session, they will be able to get the right answer. Okay. Very easy topic and I'm teaching you. So guys, make sure that you are with your book and pen ready. Okay. Mathematical reasoning. Fine. So first thing, logical equivalence. So logical equivalence is represented by P, this is equivalent symbol, or P integral Q, or P equal to Q. So these symbols are called what? Equivalence. Equal symbols. This is the first thing. Okay. And I will give you time to write. No need to worry. Second one, compound statements. This is called tilde symbol or negation. Then we got symbol like this. This is the AND symbol. This is our OR symbol. And this is called conjunction. It's very important for us to know the name of each and everything. This is called disjunction. Because in options, we may get what does this operation stands for? Disjunction, or one more term, alternation. Implies. The last one, just now we did it. Equivalent. So in the first page, logical equivalent symbol I just showed you. Please copy down this thing. This is very important. Page number 2, the compound statements, the negation. If everyone has finished writing down, let me know, say. If you finish, please message me in the chat option that you finished writing this thing. Very important for securing 2 questions correct. Okay. Yeah. Then I am here to make sure that any question you get, you will get the full mark in this. By completing the session, you will get full mark. Okay, that I guarantee you. So no need for you to worry. Negation. Represent by the symbol tilde. Tilde symbol. So I'll draw a truth table for this. Truth table for negation of P. I'm writing this thing because negation of P instead of ABC, because in examination you'll get PQ. Okay. So this is P, this is negation of P. And if you want, I'll write one more thing, negation of P. So binary operation 0 and 1. So here we got T and F, T for true and F for false. So truth means negation of truth is what? False. False means false opposite is truth. Again, negation means you'll get true and false. So the important rule you have to note down from this is the rule. This is very, very important. One is truth table, other is rule. Negation P is only true, or is only true is true only when P is false. Negation P is true only when P is false. Common sense. This is the only rule you have to note it down. Truth table is nothing but just like our 0 and 1. Okay. Like 0. 0, what is the complement? 1. What is, if you are giving F as 1, complement is 0. But in examination, you will get only TF. True false thing mainly. So rule is nothing but I just wrote it on words, that's all. Diagrammatic representation, I just wrote it on words. So please copy down this thing. If everyone has finished, let me know the same. The last page, the previous page. Yeah, this is the previous page. No need to worry. I'll be doing it. Okay. No need to worry. Copy down this thing. The last page explanation only. I'm going to do it now. Okay. No need to worry. If you know the logic gates, that same thing only, but little bit of different, that's all. You have to get used to the P and Q. If you finish copying down, please message me the same. Next is the conjunction thing. Second one, conjunction. So this is again the truth table. For P conjunction, which means AND. This is nothing but AND gate, just like our AND gate only. So I'll try to explain you the most simplest way that anyone can get full marks in this particular mathematical reasoning. Okay. So kindly do not worry or take it as very new thing. It's very easy only. Only there are some new terms which I'll be discussing. PQ, PQ and QP. So first thing 0, 0. Just like true, true. I don't true table. True, false. False, true. I think then false, false. Yeah, that'll be fine. So true and true, it will be obviously true, and Q true. True, false, false. Just like our AND gate, multiplication thing. Okay, I'll explain in detail also. This will be again false. So false into false, obviously false only. We'll get the thing. So which means what you understand from this is, or the key takeaway. Understanding for the examination point of view for KSET. P to Q is only true. Is all right. Is true only when both P and Q are true. Sometimes in the options they'll try to confuse us. So this is one of the options in one of the question paper I have taken, 998. They given this particular thing. So once you finish copying down, let me know. Please do it fast. Okay. So this is just like our AND gate, but the important thing is the understanding for the case. And this is one kind of problem where you should not go wrong at any case. This is a sure shot question, and I'm sure that each and every one attending session will get full mark. Is there anyone left to copy it down? Let me know the same. Very important for getting our two questions correct in the entrance examination. If you finish this, let me know. Yeah. The third one, disjunction. Disjunction or alternation. There is our OR statement or this particular. truth table for P to Q and this thing Q to P. This is called disjunction or PQ QP. This OR gate thing, okay? See, write the same to true, true, false, true, false. OR gate, true plus true will give true only. True plus false, true. OR is nothing but 0 plus 1, that same thing. False plus true, true. False plus false, false. So here also it will be same only, true, false. So what is the learning curve from this for CET? P disjunction Q is false only when both P and Q are false. Please note down the same. This is the important thing for the case set. They can ask an option. P disjunction. Okay, this is OR gate. This is called a disjunction thing. It's false only when both P and Q are false. And I just want to know how many of you know about exclusivity. A exclusive B or P exclusive B. Is there anyone who knows about exclusivity B? Or is there anyone who knows A exclusive B? What is the meaning of A exclusive B? No. Okay. So shall I go to the next page? Let me know that also. If you formulate this, I'll go to the next page. Yeah, fine. So I'll tell you what is exclusivity. A exclusive B. Okay, which means A bar B plus A B bar. That's it. So suppose if A value is 0 and B value is 1. So what is it? A bar is what? 1. 1 into 1. Plus what is AB bar? A value is 0. B bar is 0. 0 into 0. So 1 plus 0 is what? 1 itself. But this is if the two values are different. If two values are same, A value is 0 and B value is 0, then what is the answer? A value is 0, 1, B value is 1 to 0. What will you get? A, B bar is what? A is 0, B bar is what? 1. So answer will be 0. So in our case, this exclusivity will come for 1, what I will put? True. So for 0, what I'll put? False. So what is the learning from this? What is the learning from this particular thing? So this symbol is called what? Exclusive symbol. A exclusive, B symbol. Correct? So I can write A disjunction B is true only when one of A and B is true and other is false. One of A and B is true and other is false. So this is true only when one of A and B is true. So everyone understood what is exclusivity meaning? This is the formula for that. It won't be there in any textbook. They'll directly give these things. Please copy it down. Anyone having any doubt, ask me now. Is there anyone having any doubt in this? Let me know now. For those who don't have doubts, please comment in the chat option, no doubts. There is nothing much into it, okay? This is a dummy thing actually. There is nothing much into this. Please, you know, take these things seriously. The only way to master anything related to coding or anything is that you have to take it very coolly. You should not take it as a burden or anything. It's a dummy thing. It's very easy and I'm teaching you in the most easiest manner. Okay. Yeah, perfect. So with this, I'm going to tell you something called exclusive disjunction. Exclusive disjunction. That is P exclusive Q. Or one more symbol is there. Exclusive disjunction. This is the thing. So PQ, P exclusive Q, or I can write P exclusive disjunction of Q. Okay. True, true. Same true table I'm writing. True, false, false, true, false, false. I told you in exclusivity, what is it? This true only when one of A and B is true. So true, true means what? I'll get false. False, false means what? I'll get false itself. Only in one thing which is true, I will get it as what? True. So same explanation here. Okay, same explanation I have to write. What is it? P and Q is true only if P and Q is true only if one of P and Q is true. One of P and Q is true and the other is false. Same thing only I'm writing it down, okay? Anyone can understand this thing. So actually first standard things, these are all first standard things in coding, that's all. And again, this will help you out in your engineering, because you'll have basic electronics in your engineering. Okay, there this chapter itself is for 20 marks. That time you will get knowledge. No need for you to study at that time. Same thing only in the previous page, I just mentioned you the mathematical thing, because I want to make sure that each and every student attending this session should secure the two questions correct. All of you should get the two questions correct in your entrance examination paper. That is objective of this today's session. To make sure that two questions you should get correct. That's all. And that I will make sure, okay? No need to worry. So finish this thing, let me know the same. Fine, 2 more minutes, okay. Done? Okay. So guys, the most important thing now, so everyone listen for this particular thing, okay? Very, very important. Tautology. The most important of all, but very easy also. So this is P, this is negation of P, P conjunction or symbol. This is called what? Conjunction or symbol. Or symbol. Addition. So true, negation of P is false. If it is false, this is true. So this is always true. So what is tautology? Always true. Always true. The condition will be always true if it is tautology. If you finish drawing this thing, let me know the same. Always true. One of the options you will get it. Is it tautology, contradiction, contrapositive, something like that? Yeah, perfect. So imagine everyone is finished. So sixth one. Fallacy. Okay, not finished. Yeah, okay, fine. Perfect. Sorry guys, this is a symbol used for AND. Okay, one second. Conjunction means AND, not OR gate. Okay. Sorry for my mistake here. This is AND. Yeah, I'm in the previous page only. So guys, this is AND. This is AND gate. Okay. This one is OR gate. So if this is 0 and this is obviously it will be 1. Correct? So 0 into negation of 0. Negation of this is what? Negation P is 1. 0 into 1, 0 will get. So that's the thing. So it's always true. But for you, it's not the AND gate you have to remember in these kind of questions. It's always about what? Which is true and which is false. So I hope you have finished the same. Yeah. Fallacy thing. So the opposite of tautology is nothing but our fallacy. Okay. So it means always false. Fallacy. It's always false. So I don't think I had to draw tutorial for the same. Okay. Once you do the problems, I think you'll get it then. Same thing only, you just draw, that's it. But only thing is that for tautology fallacy thing, just erase this thing. I'll just write down fallacy, that will be much more easy for you. True, false, false, true. You'll always get false as that. Because these kind of things will be easy, difficult for you to remember, maybe. So just understand that fallacy is always false, tautology is always true. So have you finished this thing? Just understand that thing. Tautology means always true, fallacy is always false. But the important truth table you have to know is exclusive distinction, disjunction, conjunction, and negation. That will be more than enough. The last one. Implication or conditional. Implication or conditional. Because if I'm giving you the truth table like this, and then you'll have a condition of a lot of things going in the mind. So better than that, tautology means always true, fallacy means always false. So that'll be fine. So P to Q. This means what P implies Q. P implies Q. That's all. Fine. P implies Q is the main thing for this. This is the only big thing we have to note it down, and that's it. So truth table for P implies Q or Q implies P. Write the same thing first. PQ, P implies Q, Q implies P. So true, true. True, false. False, true. I think we need one more thing. The last one is false, false. So true, and then true false is false. False true is true. False false is true. So this I will tell you. Okay. T, the last two things are T, then P and F. So what you have to learn from this is P implies Q means is false only if is false only when P is true and Q is false. P implies Q. When P is true and Q is false. All are true. So I'll just show you an example also. Before you complete this thing down, I'll just show you an example. Okay. Let's take one example. This is the kind of question you will get, okay? P, it rains. Okay. Q, the crops are good. So P implies Q means if it rains, okay, the crops are good. P implies Q means if it rains, the crops are good. So this statement can be contradicted. This statement can be contradicted only in one situation, when P is true, Q is false. When P is true, Q is false. So what is it contradicting statement? That statement is, when it rains, it is true, P is true, but the crops are not good. Crops are not good. So this is only one statement which can contradict the same. So this is a physical meaning you have to understand in each and everything. So now I'll just go to the next page. You copy down this thing first, then the other thing. Then tell me when you want to go to the previous page. And once you're done with this, 2 more minutes and you'll be done with this full chapter. So no need for you to worry at all. You're sure shot to get full mark in this. Tautology fallacy, any confusion is there? Tautology, all the things are true. Whatever may be the condition, it is true. It is tautology. Fallacy meaning what? Whatever may be the condition, it is false. The next page, the previous page, yeah. See, implication or condition. P implies Q, which means what? If it rains, something like that. Only while doing problems, you will come to know. So the question is this thing, question is this thing, P it rains, Q the crops are good. So P implies Q generally means what? If it rains, the crops are good. But I told you it can be contract dictated. Once I wrote this thing, I just wrote this particular thing. The statement can be contradicted only in one situation, when P is true and Q is false. Then it rains, but crops are not good. So kindly write it down, guys. Okay. Because many of you are seeing this for the first time, because you got something in class 11th, the mathematical reasoning. Okay. The teachers won't, it is not that important for your board exam. So teachers may skip or will give least importance to this and tell you to study by yourself. So that is the reason I'm writing down in words, because one session is over and then when you have to go back, you have to remember these things. Kindly do not relax at any point of time now. Because if you're relaxing now, you're losing one mark. Okay. Kindly don't do that. Everyone is done. Is there anyone want to go to next page or anything? Let me know now. Next page. Okay. So guys, the learning from this is what? P and Q is only false when P is true and Q is false. This is a learning thing for you. So you should remember it is implication or conditional. Implication sense implies or conditional. These statements are implication or condition. This is the only thing which you have to learn. That's it. So tautology or fallacy part, again, I'm repeating, if anyone is having any difficulty in knowing the truth table, kindly do not confuse. This is not a board exam where we have to draw the truth table. Okay, fine. I'm just drawing it so that you can understand completely. For tautology or fallacy, if you have any doubt, remove that or junction or and, conjunction or distinction, whatever it is, remove it from your mind and just only remember tautology means true. Fallacy, F stands for false. T for true, F for false. That's it. As simple as that. It is much easier. Has everyone finished this thing now? If I get two yeses, I'll proceed to the last thing. One yes I got. Yeah, I got yes. Thank you. I'm good. The last one, 6th or 7th, whatever it is. Biconditional or equivalence. So guys, please concentrate. Okay, this is the most easiest questions you can get on entrance. And if you just listen to this class, I'm sure that you will get full mark. Listening. So better, I think I will draw it on the next page maybe. So before drawing the thing, I'll just tell you what it is. Okay. Biconditional equivalence. This is a symbol. Or equivalence, this particular symbol. This is a symbol used. Okay, whether we use P equivalence Q like this, or P biconditional equivalence symbol. So which means what? P is necessary and sufficient condition for Q. Condition for Q. Next one, Q is necessary and sufficient condition for P. You can just put a detail line. Okay. Third thing, if P then Q. Then Q. And if Q then P. The last one, Q if and only if P. So Q happens only if P. I'll just tell you what it is. So if we finish this thing down, I'll just write down next time. If you finish this thing, let me know. Finished. Okay, only from one person I got. Yeah, done. Okay, fine. So I'll just give an example here. If we're going to truth table, okay, if P. If P's value is, he will be successful. Q, he works hard. So P equivalence Q or biconditional Q, meaning what? This means he will be successful only if he works hard. If and only if he works hard. Yeah, I'll show you the previous page. No need to worry. Okay. Previous page I'll show you. No need to worry at all. Or you can write, Hard work is the necessary condition for success, which is true in your cases. For your success. So I just will go to the previous page. Okay. So this means P is necessary and sufficient condition of Q. Same thing. If P, then only Q. If there is hard work, then only you'll be successful. Correct? So behind every successful person, there will be hard work behind him. That's it. Q if and only if P. So success will only happen if there is hard work. That's it. So if we can understand like this, then it'll be very easy for us to do. Done. Okay. If it done, I'm just going back to this. Yeah. Please copy down the same. Put table four and we'll just write only one thing, P to Q. That'll be more than enough. If I write a lot of things, it'll be confusing you. PQ, then P to Q. First, write, draw the values of these things. True, 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 false, false, true, false, false. So true, true, I'll get what? True as the answer. False, false, I'll get true as the answer. That is also true. Only thing which is false is these two things. So which means P to Q is true only when is true only when both P and Q have the same values, have the same truth values, same truth values. This is the important thing for you. This is the most important thing. So guys, up to this, any doubt for anyone? Any doubt for anyone? Shall I go to next one? Last one, the last one. Okay. Converse, inverse, contrapositive. Conditional statement. Conditional statement. P to Q. If P, then Q. Next thing, converse of a statement. Q to P. If Q, then P. Inverse of a statement. Negation of P, negation of Q. If not P, then not Q. Last one, contrapositive. Contrapositive. Negation of Q implies negation of P. If not Q, then not P. So I'll write down the examples for each and everything. First one for conditional. If I am sleeping, then I am breathing. Converse. If I am breathing, if I am breathing, then I am sleeping. Inverse. If I am not sleeping, then I am not breathing. Contrapositive is what? The last one. Just searching for the colors. Yeah. If I am not breathing, then I am not sleeping. Guys, isn't this easy or difficult? Till this, any difficulty you had, let me know. Please copy down this thing. Understand and copy down. Nothing is there. This is all second standard, third standard things. That's all. Well below our level. Think like that and you can conquer many things. If you finish these things, let me know. So guys, just to explain to you these things, if P then Q, if I'm sleeping, I'm breathing. Converse, second term will come first. Okay, if I am breathing, then I'm sleeping. Inverse, if not P then Q. So just put not, if I am not sleeping, then I am not breathing. Contrapositive, ulta of this thing. If I'm not breathing, then I am not sleeping. Any doubt to anyone till now? So guys, any doubts till now? I just taken all of these things. Is there anyone who haven't completed the page? Let me know the same. Okay. Say I taken negation, conjunction, distinction implies equivalence, and that's it. And yeah, exclusive disjunction. Tautology means everything true. Tautology, blindly mark it. Fallacy, everything false. Fallacy. No need to know any truth table for this. Okay. If because I understood that if I'm drawing truth table, a lot of guys are getting confused. So guys, this is not a board exam. This is an entrance examination. Very easy. Anyone having any page to write down now, let me know. And did anyone feel tired today? I don't think that anyone has. So that's the reason I didn't give any break till now. Okay. Anyone having any doubt in this or any page? Yeah. Because this, we won't feel tired because this is all very easy thing. Nothing is there in this. Any pages anyone want me to do? Because I am going to do questions now. That's the reason. Okay, explain conjunction and disjunction. Sure, no problem. I'll explain to you guys, no need to worry. Okay. Conjunction, disjunction. Nothing is there actually. Conjunction and this conjunction means or get is there, right? That's all. So conjunction is and gate, and this is the distinction is or gate. Even I get confused while saying this. So conjunction is the thing, but guys, just take here as this is zero. I'll take it as maybe zero. 0001. The 0 plus 0 is what? 0 into 0 is what? 0 only. Only with? Just take this thing. 0 into 0, 0. True, false. 0 and 1. That's the thing. One second, guys. I think I'll just explain from the start, maybe. Yeah. I think, yeah, one of the students did not understand negation. Yeah, fine. 0 and 1. That's it. Negation means the opposite sign of the same. Okay, opposite sign of the same. Conjunction meaning AND gate. So true into true, zero. True into false, you'll get false only. False into true, obviously you'll get false. 0 0, this is what? 0 1 or whatever it is. Okay, this is 0 1, the false. Just like our AND true table, how many of you don't know the AND true table? Let me know. So this is only true if only P and Q are true. That's it. Only true if P and Q are true. That's all. So those who does not know true table, I'll just draw the true table for same. See, for the AND thing. What is this? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. Last one is 1, 1. Okay, 0 into 0, 0. 0, 1s are 0. 1 0 is a 0, 1. That's all. So that is only the truth table for the same. So P and Q is only true if what? Both P and Q are true. That's it. So only in this condition, both are true. 1 and 1. That's it. So now are you guys cleared with the logic? If both are true, then only our answer will be true. That is the AND gate. The next one is what? So guys, forget about truth table and everything. Only thing you have to know is the important thing which I have mentioned for the CET. See, for disjunction thing, P and Q is false only when both P and Q are false. See, when both this is false, then only I'm getting this one is false. Only when P and Q are true. So I'm just giving it as 1, 1. If I'm getting this 1, 1, this is AND gate. Simple thing. For more clear thing, I'll just give this 1, 1. Only if it is 1, 1 case, I'll get 1. The rest of the thing, it is 0. False means 0 means 0, 0. Any doubt? This is just the AND gate and the OR gate. Now, first page, I have not done anything. That is not that important also. Any other doubt? Siraj, I think your doubt has been cleared. Anyone have any doubt? For Abdul Dayan, any doubt is there? Abdul Rahman and Abdul Dayan? Because you guys are fasting, that's the reason I'm just asking, especially. Okay. Pavani, Pavani, Meghana, Kripa, Nisarga, because they all messaged me that they don't know the topic. Okay. In the beginning, I asked whether some of you guys know the topic. Then. So that's why I'm asking Kriva and Nisarga and all, Meghna, whether they understood or not. Perfect. Because guys, this is the only thing you'll get pakka two marks in this. Two questions you'll get correct. Okay, nothing is there in this. Yeah. Nothing is there. You are sure to get full mark in this thing. I'll just clear the speech. For the conjunction, the AND gate thing you have to know. For the disjunction, OR gate. That's it. No need to confuse you. No need for you to learn a lot of things and get confused on the same thing. Okay. So coming to one important thing regarding your admissions only. Okay, let me just see. Those who want to drink water can drink water. I don't have water bottle with me, so I cannot. So guys, I think 4-year higher education, okay. And the engineering thing. I don't know still about medical thing. One of the news from Indian Express is saying that, yes, for you guys, the admission will start take place from August. Classes will start from September. Okay, for engineering, the classes will start from September only. So normally it starts from June, July. Okay, July the classes actually start for the engineering guys, but for you guys, it will start only from September. So which means in May and June, maybe, I don't think in May and June, May anyway, definitely there is no entrance examinations, that's for sure. Okay, June also, it's, I don't think so. If it's in September and you'll be writing your first semester exam in January or February, January last or February, the first semester examination for engineering. Second semester, yeah. So September only your this thing will start, the engineering admissions or what, engineering college will start, and by August only you will get the admission process and everything to CET. So I don't want anyone to rush going to the colleges and take admissions. Okay, so that is actually we have to wait for the results. Okay, once the everything is listed very transparently nowadays. Okay, everything is listed very transparently, in the sense we know in each and every college how many seats are there. Because now if you go to some colleges, they'll say that the admissions will be over fast. Okay, so, but guys, now I don't think so how many colleges will take admissions. So there is a very false image. Okay, so kindly wait for the second allotment. If you're not getting a good college, wait for the second allotment. Okay, even if that is not the case, wait till the third allotment, because there is one more allotment called supplementary allotment. Okay, and people in supplementary allotment also get good colleges. You got the point. So kindly wait. Okay, do not rush on deciding to join some courses which you don't like. If you like computer science, wait for it. Don't take ECE or triple E. But if you like ECE, take that thing. Or if it like mechanical, you wait for that in your particular college. And before choosing a college, keep in mind of two things. What is the placement record there? And what all fest and what all activities they are doing. Okay, how the college can support you. Okay, so for that, you have to go to the college and you have to ask the students. 5 to 6 students, you should ask them. How is the college and everything? Because only the students can give you an honest a review on the same. Who is studying over there? Okay, but 99.9% is you won't get a positive review, because any student in any college, including myself, won't give a positive review. It'll be a mixed review. For me, I'll give just a mixed review. It won't be highly positive also. So you got the point. So no need for you to worry. And I think the examination for you guys will be on July only. Okay. So with this kept in mind, and some of the guys who joined late for my entrance coaching program. Okay. And those who did not attempt the log and anti-log thing. And there are some students who still got confusions for the log and anti-log on how to calculate. Okay. And the power cycles also. Fine. So we will have, so this is the model which I'm going to follow now, because I have to increase my productivity also. Okay. So Monday to Friday, the classes will be there. That's more than enough.
I think by next 2 weeks, I'll be completing all the papers. Okay. Then after that, I'll be getting time to edit the recorded sessions, and I'll be sending you the links. So those links are unlisted links, which means only the person who has the link can view it. You got the point. Only the person who has the link can view that particular thing. No other person in any platform cannot view it. I'll be sending you the unlisted links of the same. Okay. And every Friday we'll have a test. And in test, just like the last time it was just for 29 questions. Next it will be for 60 questions. Okay. And you have to be very honest. Okay. You have to be very honest with me while giving me the answers. Then only I can help you out personally. And for the next exam, those who are having less than 15 marks, let me know the same, less than 15. For them only, I'm inviting them for the evening sessions. Monday to Thursday, I got evening sessions. For the person who's getting less than 15 in the next Friday examination. Friday, next one, I'll keep math maybe. Okay. Once let me complete all the question paper of 2000, the last 20 year paper. Okay. You got the point. Then we can do it. And simultaneously, I need all your hard work also on the same. So whatever things, whatever question paper I'm sending you the answer key, you have to try it. Because we got plenty of time. So we should not relax also. You got the point. So you got plenty of time. So guys, so Saturday and Sunday, there won't be any class because see, my health is also a big problem because even I have to be active in this point of time. Okay. And there are a lot of preparation for me to do for setting up your question papers. You got the point. Yeah. I have to set up the question papers here and I have to make sure that slides, everything has to be kept properly. Okay. So you just take, if you want, see, for example, today's session I got from morning 8 to 5 p.m. I got session. Today, morning 8 o'clock to 5 p.m. So which means almost how many hours? I think it's a lunch break. I'll just take some time. That's it. Half an hour. So more than 6 or 7 hours of classes is there, which is not good for anyone's health. Okay. We can watch movies for 5 to 6 hours. That's a different story. But teaching for this much amount of time causes a mental strain. Okay. So today my productivity is increased because yesterday nothing I did, no classes, nothing. Okay. I just relaxed the whole day. Okay. Fine. And I'm very sorry that I couldn't reply to most of you. Only for the students who messaged me in the evening, I just messaged them back. Okay. So I couldn't reply to anyone. So thank you so much for all your care. So I was recovered fast. Only thing was I was preparing much more than what is required because I was preparing more than you guys so that I can give you the best class. You got the point. And taking 7 days a week is not a joke because I love doing it and I want each and every one of you to benefit from it. You got the point. Because once session is over, I may have to clear the doubts of some of my students. Not only this time, maybe at 7:30 also. Okay. So there'll be a lot of students asking me a lot of doubts. Okay. So that is the thing. But if you are able to do 5 to 6 hours of hard work, obviously everyone will land up in less than 1,000 rank. I'm telling you, those who are getting less than 3,000 rank, no, they'll just study 7 hours. 7 hours productively. Okay. 7 hours productively. Productivity should be improved. Even if with 1 hour you are able to do one chemistry paper of CET, that will be perfect. Read each and every line of NCERT chemistry book, an NCERT exemplar, chemistry exemplar. You'll get a lot of options. These are the things which is required. Okay. We don't need to refer any other book. When I was studying, what book I referred was Pradeep's. now currently people refer SL Aurora, I think so. Pradeep physics chemistry, I used to refer SL Aurora physics chemistry. Now there's a trend, but now if you're what doing Pradeep's, this is the wrong thing, because that was 20 years ago. They are not updated anything. They are still reprinting the same edition and giving. Okay, so that is not the right approach in the education, because the papers has been changing rapidly. You got the point. So SL Aurora, you can definitely study this for JEE mains if you're writing, or the NEET also. Fine. But you have to open the book. H.C. Verma, I did not study at all. So it is told something like for getting to IIT, you have to study H.C. Verma, but that is not required. I only heard it when I came to teaching, that this book exists or not, H.C. Verma. Okay. Because we don't discuss on what book we studied in engineering once you come to engineering. Once you come to engineering, it's a new different level altogether. Fine. So I think everyone is okay with this. Any doubt? So then I'll go to the questions, guys. So only thing is that do not join any colleges or do not pay any advance fees anywhere. Okay. That's the only thing you can tell. For your own thing, because the fees is very less, come through CET. That's it. Or NEET. First question, let P price increase. Q, demand falls. So statement is statement. Okay. Statement. If demand IF. If demand does not fall, then price does not increase. Okay, so options I'll give you: A, Q implies P; B, negation of Q. I'll give, yeah, negation of Q implies negation of P; and C, negation of Q equivalence or biconditional negation of P; and D, negation of Q implies P. So guys, what is the answer for this? A, B, C, D. These are all made up questions. That's it. I'm getting 2B, then C is I'm getting the answer. Let me see correct one. C again I'm getting. Only from 7, 8 people I got 10 people. Yeah, that's it. Others? Let me just call the names then. D. Okay. Okay. B, C, B. B, B, B. That's it. Option B. So let me count the number of options. What I got? 3, 4, 5. Then 6, 7 Bs I got. C, let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 Bs. Eight Bs now. So guys,
what is this thing? This meaning, the meaning of this particular thing. Okay. Then. Implies then. This is what? The equivalence thing. Correct. I think a lot of guys got confusion in equivalence or this thing. See, if demand does not fall, then the price doesn't increase. So what is the meaning of this? If I am not breathing, then I am not sleeping. Contra positive. Contra positive is the answer for the same. Contra positive. Yes. The answer of this is what? Contra positive. Option B. Contra positive. Let me see who has given me C as answers. Logical guys only has given me C as answer. B. Good. Gautam Prakash. Good. Rujita, I think now you got it. But others, kindly do not be silent in this case, okay? Be violent now. Show your all the things here only now. Amog. Okay. Show down your answers. Okay. And be highly competitive. This is a competitive examination. This is not a laid back examination where we can sit coolly and in the bed and with a laptop on the pillow or something. We cannot do that. Highly competitive nature. So please do the same. Tarun. I think Tarun has given me, I think so, the answer. So I have to make sure that everyone, because most of you guys I have not seen and you are not seen me. Okay. So whomever I have seen them, just calling their names. Aditya and all gave me correct answer. Any doubt in this? Any doubt in this? So guys, it won't come as biequivalence. Why? What is biconditional biequivalence thing? Both P and Q should have the same truth values. Okay. So this is complete negation. It is out of question. Contra positive. Okay. Let me one more question. Which of the, these are all made up question mostly. Following is not a statement. Not a statement. Okay, guys. Option A. 2 is an odd number. This is without logic I'm giving. 10 is less than 8. 3, the number 13 is prime. The last one, please do me a favor. Common sense we have to use in this. That's it. Mathematical reason is all about common sense. Guys, it's not about logic. Okay. The question is, which of the following is not a statement? 2 is an odd number is false, but we are not telling any semantics here. Let me shoot out your answer. Don't be afraid. This is not your CET examination. All the answers are correct only. Please shoot the thing. The question is, it is not a statement. Okay, this is the question. Not a statement. That's it. Only this much answers. I told you this is not a logical thing. Okay. This is not about logic. It's a statement thing. You know what is statement before this. Okay. I'm getting a lot of an A, B, C, D. Everything is there. Okay. So guys, most of you has given me the correct answer. The correct answer is what? Option D. Please do me a favor. Okay. Yes. Option D. Please do me a favor. So any sentence learning for you. There's an English class I'm taking now. Any sentence. Okay. Which is a request or a command. Is not a statement. Clear, guys? See, 2 is an odd number. Okay, we know it's false, but who cares? It's a statement. It may be true or false. 10 is less than 8. After this much of teaching, I'm not in a mood to think. I don't care whether this is a statement. I'm not going to the logical thing. Please write down these things. Whomever got the wrong answer, especially, please write down this thing. Do not leave anything what I say today, okay? Because 2 questions will come for your entrance examination. And I want each and every one of you to get full mark in that. Kindly write it for me. Okay, kindly write it for me. That's it. Finished, everyone? Everyone is finished? I think, yeah, then fine. Fourth one, okay, Venn diagram question. I have to make sure that I write on each and everything, Venn diagram thing. I think everyone know what is a Venn diagram. I'll try to confuse you guys. U stands for universal. This is T, this is P. So the statement is, you would identify, no policeman is a thief. Which diagram in this? No policeman is thief. Homer has given me the answers correct, but only 3 people have sent me the answer. Correct. 4th guy correct. Correct. Yeah, this is the question number 3, guys. Sorry. This is question number 3. For me, I just wrote. So that note, you please leave it, okay? So guys, coming to this, the answer is option B for this. It's not D. What is option D? I think two of my students just give me option D as the answer. Option D in the sense, T stands for thief, P stands for police. Okay. Option D stands for what? All thief are police. So these kind of problems are called what? Syllogism. Syllogism. Okay. Option D and option is almost same only. Option C and option D are same. Anyway. Option B, some policemen are thief. Some police are thief. Or some thief are police. Doesn't matter anyway. Option P and option D, they're not even touching each other. So no police is thief. Here, what does it mean? All thief are police, or some police are, all thief are police. That is the meaning of this. All thief are police. That is the meaning of this. Or some police are thief. That's it. Here, the physical meaning of this is what? All thief are police. If I draw one more diagram here, so T for thief, P for police, G for gangster, we'll say. Okay. T for thief, P for police, G for gangster. So what is the condition? All thief are police. All police are gangsters. All thief are gangsters. These are the conclusion which can make from the Venn diagram. This is called syllogism. You will hear it, all of these things, okay? You will hear each and everything in future, these things, syllogism. When you're preparing for your aptitude examinations. So finished, guys, finished these things. Have you finished it? If you finish it, let me know the same. Previous page, yeah. I'll show you all the pages, no need to worry. Let us discuss this question, first question. Don't see what I have worked it down, that is actually waste. But can you try doing this first question? Negation of P. Correct? And what is the symbol? And. Conjunction. Q is logically equivalent to which one? How many of you don't know this thing? Let me know the same. If you're unable to know these things, still not sure about this, then I have to give you some other questions. I think then I do the question, then we'll do it. Still not sure. So guys, we'll do something which you are sure with.
which of the following of the inverse is a proposition if a number is a prime, then it is odd. Inverse meaning what? Not. If number is not prime, then it is not odd. Is question number second clear to everyone at least? Is question number second clear to everyone? Yep, then fine. So guys, before going to the other question, I want to do one more thing. Okay. The condition for implies P is what? First option, neither tautology nor contradiction. Second one, tautology. Third one, contradiction. Fourth one, none of the above. I'll just erase it and write neatly. Yeah, this thing, the condition for P, okay, and Q implies P is which one? Correct, only one person has sent me the answer is correct. So guys, go to this truth table if you don't know. Okay. We're not going for the tautology thing. See, this is P and this is Q. Just see this truth table. Wait. This is P. True, true, true. What is this true? P only, right? So P, conjunction or and, Q, I'm getting it as what? P. So both are true. If everything is true, what it is called? If everything is true, what is called? Tautology. That's it. Are you clear now? Just go to truth table and just see this thing. Tautology condition is what? P conjunction. Q should give me P, which means in tautology, everything should be true. Correct. So what is the answer of this? Tautology. How many of you got the answers tautology? How many of you got it? I think Gautam got it. I think he's the only person to message me for this question, tautology. Very good. So to Monisha has got it. Meghna got it. Very good. How many of you did not understand this thing? This is one of the entrance questions, guys. That's it. Finished? If you finished, then I'll write it here. before going to the next one, I will just give you one small thing.
Then I'll understand. Everyone send me this answer in WhatsApp. The one which I'm going to do it. The inverse of the proposition. P and or whatever it is. Q into R is option one. R implies P. Yeah. Everyone do this thing. You know what is an inverse, right? That's it. P, this symbol is for and conjunction. That's all. I've given you each and everything. Please do this and let me know the answers. Inverse. How many of you don't know how to do this? Please message me now. I don't want to waste your time. Those who don't know, please message me this also. Kuldeep, your answer is correct. If anyone does not know, message me now how you're feeling difficulty. So one guy has given me the right answer, but again, he's thinking it's correct or not. Not sure. Send me the answer in WhatsApp. Thank you.
See, truth table will be same for everyone, okay? Send me the answer, send me the working. Then only you'll come to know what you're doing. Anyone? Oh, I don't have the phone. Okay.
Okay, fine. Who is having difficulty in this problem? Who is not unsure on how to do this thing? So guys, this is a very easy question. First thing, which I told you, first thing, we should not take this question very seriously. This is a dummy question. First thing. I'll just start from scratch. Don't take this question seriously, okay? Inverse of P implies Q is what? Negation of P implies negation of Q. Correct? Now, according to our question, inverse of P and this Q, that's it, implies R.
I think I'm now getting the WhatsApp answers from each and every one, I think so.
R is negation of P to what? The and Q and in place of R. Negation of R. The negation symbol you have to put. But see the question here, negation of Q is there. So for that reason, I'll just put one negation symbol here. According to the question, I'm just mapping it. Now I'm just taking this negation thing inside. So what I'll get? Negation of P and will become or negation of Q, Q implies negation of R. I'm just taking it inside, that's it. One second, guys, I just missed. I know that it's option C. Now let me just check your answers. Correct. I think only one student has given me the correct thing till now. So guys who did not understand this thing, let me know. Those who did not understand, let me know the same. So this for, I'm just explaining one more time for the students who did not understand. Okay, nothing much is there. First thing is what? Inverse of P. P implies Q. Correct? This is not negative of, negation of P to negation of Q. Second step is what? Inverse of this particular thing, P to Q. So that will give negation of P to negation of Q to negation of R. But see, now coming to this question, our question, what is our question? Our question is this thing, P and negation of Q to R, correct?
So which means this implies R. So just put negation of P to this thing, negation of Q implies R. Nothing is there. Negation of P, this and negation of Q, Q implies negation of R. That's it. Is there anyone who did not understand this thing till now? It's option C is the answer. Third one is the answer. Yeah. Is there anyone who did not understand this thing?
So give me 1 minute of time. Okay, 1 minute. Please copy on the same. Yeah, I'll definitely explain the first question of the CET paper. So there are a lot of questions like this, which is very easy. So please copy down this thing. Once you're done, let me know the same. So coming to our CET question now, negation of P and Q is logically equivalent to which one? P implies Q, Q implies P. Anyway, it cannot be P implies Q and Q implies P. There is no chance for that. It will be either option C or option D. Negation of P implies Q or negation of Q implies P. So guys, come to the truth table for the same. Now then only understand better. So our question in this is what? Negation of P to Q. This is our question. Is that our question? Let me just confirm the same. Negation of P to Q. There is no bracket. There is no bracket. Okay. Yeah, this is our question. I just confirmed it. This is equivalent to which one? So suppose our question is negation of P and Q. What is the equivalence of this particular thing? What is the equivalence? Can anyone tell me what is the equivalence of this thing? What is this equal to? Negation of P to Q will give me what? Only one guy is replying to me.
Is there anyone who did not understand this thing? Let me know that also, because this is a very critical question. Is there anyone who did not understand this thing? Negation of P to Q. Is there anyone who did not understand this particular question? So only two people have sent me the answer. That is the reason I'm just asking. So negation of P to negation of Q. That's it, right? This is a negation P to the negation of Q. Now coming to our question in this. What is our question here? I'm just writing it down here itself. I'll forget space somewhere. I'll just write it down there. Yeah, I think I'll just clear this thing and write it down. See, guys. Negation of P to Q. Correct? Or else you can say negation of P to our this Q is logically equivalent to what? There is a question. Negation of Q to P by using what? By using the truth table. And one more thing, negation of P to the and Q. This can be either written as what? Negation of P to the negation of Q, or else I can also write it as what? Negation of P conjunction, disjunction of the or thing to the negation of Q. So what is the answer of this? Option D is the answer of this particular question. Option D is the answer. Yes. So I just written the same thing. Negation of P to what conjunction of Q gives? Negation of P disjunction of negation of Q. The same as by using the truth table. Negation of Q to P. How many of you did not understand? Let me know. Did not understand this thing. So those who did not understand can stay back, others can leave. So guys, in the question, it's a whole negation. Okay. In the question, it's a whole negation thing. I think they might have missed that bracket. It's a whole negation, the question. It's a whole negation in the question. Yeah. Those who have not understood this thing, let me know the same. Okay, bye-bye. Is there anyone who haven't understood this thing? So this is by using the truth table, okay guys? By using the truth table only you're doing it. So you have to know the truth table well. So for anyone who didn't understand, let me know. See, for that you have to know the truth. You just see the truth table, you'll get it. You just work out on the truth table today. Once the session is over, you see this, copy on the same thing and just work out on the truth table. And still, if you did not get it, I'll explain to the next class. Work out on the truth table, the same thing. You'll definitely get the answer. Just try from your end. Try from your end and then let me know the thing. Okay. Okay. Okay, guys, then bye-bye and take care.